You still look like this to me.
Well, Nikki, yeah, you still make me feel like that, so it's all good.
I do not. How dare you? You ugly bitch. How dare you?
Who said that?
You cat.
It was me.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Memoirs of a Stage, right here on YouTube. Please remember, we do not own the rights to any music played here today.
As always, we are using Zoom to bring this episode of Memoirs of a Stage from our living room
to yours.
So if there's any mistakes, any audio blips, anyone freezes, sorry about it.
And in case you can't tell, we have a very special guest with us today.
It's me!
It's Miss Nikki Chin! Hello, Nikki! Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you so much for allowing me to be here.
And boy, do we have a fun topic to discuss with you today.
Scandalous costumes, precise painting, custom hair pieces, and witty personalities are just some of the quirks that can give a queen their signature persona. And from time to time, as we navigate our career, we pick up a catchy song or two that speaks to our persona and continues to follow us as we grow and grow as an entertainer.
And we are going to be looking back on some old performances that bring these quirks to life for you right here on this episode. Okay, so tell me, Nikki, what is a quirk to you?
Well, thank you so much for that question, Sapphire. I really appreciate that question. Honestly, a quirk for me on stage especially, is something that kind of brings to life the song that you're doing or the character that you're trying to portray on stage. Myself specifically, if you're asking me specifically, I don't do characters. I don't really dress up and impersonate anybody else. I'm more of a dancing queen. I'm more of a talent-inspired performer. So what I like to do and how I choose my music is not only for the audience, but for me. Music that I love performing to, music that means something to me, whether it's from, you know, it's nostalgic to me from a movie that I watched when I was 10 years old even, or a movie that I just watched maybe. And so I kind of bring that on stage and I kind of emote that quirk, as you will, to the audience in hopes that they kind of can feel it from me and that they can feel my emotions in this song and they will join me in it.
Absolutely. I totally relate to that. I think I would define a quirk as something a little bit off kilter from what most people would think as your sort of your shtick or your persona, or a little outside the box typically. And for me, a lot of quirks that I like to do is music choice. So I like to always sort of play with different genres of music and different styles, and songs that aren't necessarily, you know, top 40s, what everyone's going to be singing along to, what everyone's going to know, but songs that really sort of embody the story that I'm telling on stage. So for example, the performance that I've chosen today is actually one of my favorite mixes that I've ever made myself, that I've only ever performed once for our very first show at the Guelph Concert Theatre Hall in, I guess, 2019. So I chose a mix that took a song that was on the radio at the time, but no one really knew. And just told a little story with it, a brand new costume and everything, and it's really awesome. I also really love the video. But I also took that song and performed it one other time at Cruise and Tango's, and let's just say she did not make money during that number. Nobody knew the song, nobody was feeling it. And I think it really sort of sums up how I look at quirks and how I use those sort of quirky things to enhance my performances. So I'm presenting to you this video shot by our wonderful friend Kathy Sparkles at Guelph Concert Theatre Hall in 2019. Check it out.
Yes!
Wow. Yeah. Oh my God. So good. So good.
Thank you.
Jeez, that's Thank amazing. You. I'm like, wow. did I oversell it?
Thank you guys. So, Rachel, what does a quirk mean to you?
Well, when I think of a quirky number, I think of something that is unique and something that will make me uniquely me. For me, a quirky number starts off with a random song on a playlist. And I just download a few new songs and put them on a playlist in the hopes that of these 20 new songs, one or two of them will actually make it to stage. And for me, the quirk is the song that comes off that playlist and onto the next one. And just kind of, I just want to sing it in my head and I take the headphones off and it's there. And you know, when I'm not sure about an audience or if I'm on a new stage or something, I will take one of these quirky, fun songs that might not have been a top 40, might not have been the most popular thing, might have actually been heard on the radio at some point still. So some people might know it, they might not know it, but they might not see it in the light that I paint for them when I bring this special number to stage. And it's usually something that empowers me, something that just makes me want to go for it, you know? And that's just the sort of drive I need to kick my ass on stage sometimes. As you see in the clip that I am about to show that was filmed by the amazing Kathy Sparkles. Check it out.
Thank you.
very good.
Good.
Really love that performance. I also really love the outfit and the hair you're wearing because, one, love the hair, one of my favorite hairs, and two, the outfit is one of my favorite outfits.
I remember performing at that on that stage, and it's such an amazing stage to perform at, and you can really feel, you can really see that you're utilizing it very well. So wow,
yeah, the feeling from the audience and everything was amazing that day, and sort of the outfit is kind of like a traditional racial kind of thing to wear on stage in some way or another. So it kind of brought the whole quirk together, I think. So tell me, Nikki, what sort of connection do you draw from a quirky number? Is it an emotional connection? Is it an empowering connection? What connects you to your performance to make you want to bring it to life again and again and again?
Well, honestly, it's all of that. It is an emotional connection. It is an entertainer's connection to the actual number that I'm doing. But I like to make sure that I enjoy doing the number before I actually do it, because we emote so much on stage, whether it's verbally with a microphone, acting it out, presenting it, or dancing it. And I mean, we all try and kind of give it 100% on all of them, but there are a couple parts that kind of need to take a hit. So with the numbers that I do, it's very emotionally driven. It's very enjoyable for myself to do it. So I like that I'm doing it. And so the audience for me will also enjoy that I'm doing it.
I totally agree. I mean, if I'm choosing to do something, I have to enjoy it for the most part. And for me, the main thing that attracts me to something that could be considered quirky is always the storytelling aspect. I'm always trying to tell a story on stage. And if I find a song that really fits the story that I'm telling, then I don't care if it's popular or if it's random. I don't care if it's another language or if it's never been heard before by anybody but myself. The storytelling is like the number one thing that I like to choose. So choosing a quirky number, I want to be able to tell the story. And I also want to do something that will make me stand out. So sometimes when you're doing a show in a whole cast of queens and everyone's doing the Britneys and Madonnas and the Chairs and the Tina Turners and Aaron, those amazing numbers that we all love and we want to sing along to, it can be refreshing to come out with something a little bit different, a little bit off, to really sort of cleanse the palate and keep people's interests, keep them unsure of what's going to happen. So they're always intrigued and their interest is piqued. And that's my goal as a performer, is always to, my tagline is I never do the same thing twice. And that's what I want to do.
That is amazing. It's funny how you brought that into the idea of characters and everything, because a lot of people, when they see me on stage, they know me as a character entertainer. They know me as an impersonator. They know that I can bring many other people to life on stage. It is one of the many things I love about drag, is being able to step into somebody else's shoes. What I love about my quirky numbers is I'm stepping into my own shoes. When I am putting this quirky number on stage, I am no longer becoming that Reba or that Celine. I am bringing forth a piece of my personal identity, a piece of me that I don't usually share with a lot of people, because as when I'm not on stage, I like to be in the corner and observe the room. I don't necessarily like to be the center of attention. And so when I find a quirky number that speaks to me, what I'm really presenting to the stage is something that is uniquely me and not a character that I've stepped into, but actually me myself on stage. And that's what really draws me to making one of these quirky numbers.
Absolutely. I really agree with that. And also something that I think is really important for people to sort of understand, that sometimes an artist is bearing their soul out there on stage, and a song choice can really help do that from a very sort of safe perspective. Like, you're not necessarily going, I'm doing like, hello, let me tell you my life story. I tripped over a Lego block when I was 5 and I fell down. you're going out there and you're using other people's words to tell a story, which is makes it sort of a universal experience and allows people to connect with you on a different level.
So, and at the same time, you're almost opening your own diary to your soul and letting the rest of the world see another part of you.
Absolutely.
So tell me, Nikki, what do you have prepared to show our guests this evening?
So I have prepared for you a song that I hold near and dear to my heart, not only because it's a song that I did all the time, but it's a good song. And when I was reigning as Empress 30 of the Imperial Court of Toronto, raising money for our community here in Toronto, this was my song that I did at every single out of town coronation that I went to. And it just became this song that I wanted to do all the time. And I like it so much because, I mean, the lyrics are amazing. It's the musicality of it is like groovy, but not too dancey. Like, so it's kind of sensual, but still with like an upbeat. So I think that kind of envelops what I like to do as a number. That's not too much, but it's not a ballad. So this is a perfect number. And I mean, I hope that you guys enjoy it. This video was also shot by Kathy Sparkles, which is amazing.
I like digging holes and hiding things inside them. When I go all down home, I won't go get to find them. Cause I've got memories and travel like gypsies in the night. I build a home and wait for someone to tear it down. Then pack it up in boxes, head for the next town. Cause I've got memories and travel like gypsies in the night.
God, so good. And honestly, such a classic Nicki Chin number. Honestly,
I cannot hear that song without seeing you perform it in my head. And I can't, I've seen other people perform it. And honestly, I'm always like, well, why are you even trying?
Why is it so good?
I really loved it. I saw you do that performance and you did this thing where you put your hands like this and put one shoulder up and you did the whole like walk to the front of the stage with shoulder in this like skin tight gown. And I was just like, I like this. Good.
And gown made by Rachel Temptation, probably.
Probably. Outfit you were wearing in the video, because I've seen you wear that top quite a few times, but I've never seen it with the thing hanging from just below it.
Yeah.
And I was like, ooh, I love the little tiny things that spice up a performance and an outfit.
So that's, that jewelry is Amped Accessories, the earrings, and that's actually a necklace.
Ooh.
That's underneath that I left dangling, because obviously I can't wear a necklace with that crop or with that top.
Yeah.
And in, like that whole set's a, it's a crown, earrings, and a necklace. And I thought to just use it in that way because I think it went perfectly with it. And it kind of fills in the space. I have a long torso. It fills in the space from like my bust to my waist. So it's kind of nice to have that, that jewel right there. Yeah. It was fun to do.
I really love that. Thank you everyone for watching, and a huge thank you to our special guest, Miss Nicki Chin, for joining us on this very special episode of Memoirs of a Stage.
Thank you so much for having me. It was such a pleasure. You two are amazing people. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
As always, you can find us on our usual pieces of social media. You can find Sapphire and I each and every week live on Instagram on our other show, Isolation, where we have all kinds of quirky things happening each and every week. You can also check us out on YouTube. All three of us have a YouTube channel, so please go ahead and check them out. The links are below. While I'm at it, don't forget to click like and subscribe to this video right now. You can also find us on Facebook. You can find us on Instagram. You can find us on Twitter. You can find Sapphire at patreon.com/sapphirepoison, where you can subscribe to see hers and all kinds of other amazing pieces of artwork. Don't forget, you can also follow Nicki Chin at Cooking with Chin, both on Instagram and on YouTube, where she has some amazing cooking tutorials just for you in this pandemic season.
And Nicki, what have you got going on during the pandemic that people can check out?
Thank you for that question. I have a lot going on during this pandemic, especially with my Instagram and my YouTube, Cooking with Chin. And I cook every single day. I post pictures. I have made videos for YouTube, simple recipes that you can make at home. And I have new ones coming up hopefully this summer. So I'm very excited to be doing that in the next couple months. I'm also raising money for charity as we do this. I am currently the Regent Empress Terrain 34 of the Imperial Court of Toronto. And what we do each and every single year is that we raise money for our community here in Toronto. So this year, the charity that I've chosen to raise money for is PWA, the People with AIDS Foundation, their food program. And so I've been doing live streams and posting on social media. And I mean, the link is right below. So, I mean, if you want to find out more about the Imperial Court of Toronto, you can visit tycott.ca. You can visit us on Instagram. We have a YouTube channel as well. There's so much happening. So yeah, I'm keeping myself quite busy.
We love to see it. Thank you everyone for joining us tonight. And we hope you have a wonderful, wonderful night. Don't forget to follow us and we'll see you all on the next video. Bye.